the subject of my talk has been already studied for the group from Antwerp. And I think the contribution here is just to understand some very specific vortex patterns that may emerge within normal approximation. And I would like to mention to people that is involved in this work somehow. First of all, Belisa, she's a master student in the conservation program in Recife. She has been in Antwerp for 3 months this year, and she has been working on forbidden lists in the magnetic dipole. And I would like also to mention Glacio. So Glacio is professor in the university here. Well, first of all, as in this workshop, there are be some students, and I would like just to mention some what you see for some superconducting intercepts. Well, after that, I would like to review some words from the recent conducting lists, that is, the magnetic dipole. Well, I will present the direct description we use and what are the configurations that we make. And after that, I will draw some conclusions. Well, first of all, let's define what I mean by saying vortex. So, a vortex, what I call a vortex, would be a velocity field of something, maybe mass or fluids or charge of the parts and superconductors which circulates around the core. And if you integrate along a closed path, and if this path does not enclose the core, you have zero circulation. But if you encircle the core close to the core, and another question describes how the currents so, experimental realizations of this is an experiment by Tisman Schwab with a bigger decoration for on top of niobium, and you see excitable lattices which can be differently oriented. So, I would like to describe what is the direct approach that we use. First of all, we consider just a magnetic dipole, which is at a certain height from the distance. And I assume that the magnetic dipole is aligned with this main axis. And in our approximation, we use the approximation which we neglect the magnetization factors. In fact, it happens when the effective penetration length or the non-penetration length, if you have both, is much larger than the disk size. So our calculation would be, for this case, and also when the vortex, intervortex separation is much larger than the coherent length. So in this limit, we can say that the magnetic field is just approximately the external magnetic field, and not necessarily the magnetization. In this limit, we have to solve the Lowell equation. What's the advantage of doing this? Is that we have analytical expressions. Of course, if you want to only have maybe a more appropriate when you want to understand the relation of the order parameter, but as long as you are in this limit, you may have analytical expressions which may remind you of some features. So, the Lowell approximation in the Lowell gauge is given by this formula can be written like this, where that the current vector potential and the gradient of the phase, and the long approximation to the gradient of the phase of the electron beam is just this expression. Or you may write it in terms of the streamline function, which is function is related to the curl. So the curl of this function is related to the curl. This function is used in fluids just to describe the velocity fields when have a fluid some flow. And for the dipole, our vector potential is described by this expression. Well, just to know which forces are acting, the forces, we use the Lorentz forces. So if you can calculate the sheet current, you can find the Lorentz force. And after that, by knowing the forces, we integrate the equation of motion by the Stefan equation of motion. Just use observe all forces, what's the importance in it. And also we can calculate the London, it is really going to be in the London limit. Well, these are the plots of the confinement potential for the dipole. What's the confinement potential? When you have a streamline function, which is related to the current, so the magnetic dipole produces shift currents, and the shift currents are related to some kind of, well, the streamline function of the external field. And the streamline function for the external
from the physical department of Rural Federal University of Rio de Janeiro. And this talk about the penetration of magnetic fields in particles superconductors. And the view of time magnetic is called Landau equation.
Okay.
And so I started studying time magnetic is called Landau equation less than 6 months ago, so I will show you my experience. And after introduction, I will show to you these two problems. I spread superconductor with this heat. I had a problem to understand the same problem with the polar center, which was shown by F. Sardella yesterday. So I gave up the idea to produce this code. So I had only a nice speech in this way. And another example is a plasma of quartz. And the type 2 superconductors in terms of the magnetic field is characterized by two critical magnetic fields, the lower magnetic field and the upper magnetic field. The lower magnetic field, the system is in the superconducting state, and above the upper critical field is in normal state. And in this, when I am working in this state, mixed state, when there is a persistence between, there is a persistence of magnetism and superconductivity. The magnetism is the center of this box, this line here that has two lamps that has two characteristic lamps. One of them is the coherent lamp, and another one is the long penetration lamp. To tell the truth, I am working. Everything that I show here is only this line, because my simulation is done by the temperature equals zero. But I can, it's only variable, so I can say. herself 2 bodies, 3 bodies, etc. But she couldn't observe only 1 body. It's my motivation to talk about the prayer of bodies. In order to solve this problem, to show my results, I solved this 2 equations here in geometry. First of all, I must tell that I solved these 2 equations in a bidimensional surface, not like as you showed yesterday. She's working with a 3-dimensional system. I'm working with a bidimensional system. So I have here the first this Bolognese equation where C is the other parameter of supercomputer state, and it's not the first principle number equation. The second one is the second principle number equation where we have the time dependence of the potential value. So basically we want to